Welcome to another webisode of Outdoor Cast Iron Cooking. I'm Dean, the fog crawler.
Hi, I'm Joni, the teardrop nanny.
Today we're going to be doing Jamaican jerk oxtails.
Jerk is a way of cooking in the Caribbean, and whichever spices or herbs you like to use, you can't go wrong with it.
Besides cooking the oxtails, we're going to show you how to make your own green seasoning and jerk rub.
Stay tuned.
I've rinsed and washed my oxtail. Now I'm going to soak it in some lemon water. I could have also used vinegar, but I opted for the lemon water. And I'm going to let this soak for about an hour. While the oxtail is soaking, I'm going to get my dry portion of the marinade together. I'm going to start off with 3 tablespoons of the jerk rub that we found. To that, I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of coarse black pepper, 1 teaspoon of thyme, 1/2 teaspoon of cinnamon, 1/2 teaspoon of nutmeg. I'm going to add 1/4 teaspoon of ground ginger, 1/4 teaspoon of ground clove. I'm going to add 1/4 teaspoon of cayenne pepper. I'm going to mix this together to blend it evenly. Now I can get the oxtail and roll the oxtail in the dry rub. Now I'm going to coat the oxtail with the dry rub. Now that the oxtail is well coated with the dry rub, we're going to go to the wet part of the marinade. And I have to hand it off to Joni. She's going to show you how to put together the green seasoning.
Of the many times that I've traveled to the Caribbean, I've seen green seasoning, sometimes called Caribbean green seasoning, made with many different ingredients. But of course, the main thing is greens in them. Vegetables and herbs. For Jamaican green seasoning today, I'll be using organic thyme, oregano, tarragon, parsley. Some of the vegetables will be celery, including the leafy stalk, green onions, garlic, and yellow onion, as well as mixing them up with extra virgin olive oil. Want to make sure that everything gets a good bath and gets thoroughly cleaned and then patted dry. For the oregano, thyme, tarragon, and parsley, I'm going to use the stems of these. Some of the other organic greens or that you can use include a bay leaf, dill, a basil. It just kind of depends on what do you have in your pantry, your garden, or what's available at the market. When it comes to your vegetables, I have yellow onion. I'll peel it and I'll put it in some big chunks. The green onion I chopped up into, so there's about thirds or quarters. And for the celery, I want to use it with the top leaf. I have some garlic that I picked out of the garden, and I'm going to take those cloves. I'll kind of chunk those up also. You'll need to use a blender or a food processor when you get ready to put all your ingredients together. Just to show you, this is some of the elephant garlic that we've dried and came from the yard. This is a clove of garlic. What I used was a bulb and a half. So huge amount of garlic is okay with me. The onions have been chopped up. We've got yellow onions, green onions, the celery's chopped up, including the leaf. And before you say, hey, where's this? Hey, where's that? That's not the way we make it. It can be made in different ways. You can include the pimento seeds. You can include a green bell pepper, or you can include something else that you have in your pantry or your marketplace. Scallions are okay. You decide what you can put in it. In the food processor, I have one yellow onion and a bulb and a half of the elephant garlic. I want to do the onion first because I want to get those onion juices. I'll turn the food processor on and get it mixed up a bit. Next, I'll add in the celery, including the leaf, and the green onion. As you can see, it reduces down quite a bit and it starts to get a nice bit of liquid to it. Then I'll go ahead and put in the parsley, tarragon, thyme, and oregano, stems and all, because the stems will help add to the flavor. Of the herbs that I have laid out there, I pulled off any brown leaf, threw in about half the amount that I had originally laid out, but I want to put in the most of the parsley, and I'll also add in some extra virgin olive oil. All right, pour in some of the olive oil. I'll add in some water right now, not much more than a third of a cup. Now it's ready to blend, or food process in this case. Now that it's gone down a ways, I can add some additional parsley and some more tarragon, oregano, and thyme. Okay, Fog Crawler, give it a taste.
Wow, now I know why they call it green seasoning. I think I just ate a whole salad in a half a spoon.
I prepared this green seasoning on a Saturday because we're going to cook the oxtail on Sunday. One of the things we're going to be using is a Red Lion jerk sauce, which is a Humboldt-grown peppers. And this is a local sauce, Gaskin's Red Lion, and it's made locally in Arcata, California. This marinade had some of the things in it that we didn't necessarily get in our dry rub or in the green seasoning. So it does include things like the Scotch bonnet peppers and bay leaf. Also, some of the things that might not be in our spice rub, like black pepper, ginger, cinnamon, nutmeg, allspice. This is a locally made one, and it's really good. It's got a sweet and savory sauce. It's really good for vegetables and meats. So bringing the Caribbean flavors right to our plate locally is Red Lion jerk sauce marinade.
So for the wet mixture of the marinade, I'm going to start off with 2 tablespoons of the green seasoning. About a tablespoon of ketchup. I'm going to put in some W sauce. Some soy sauce. About a tablespoon of jerk sauce. And the last ingredient to go in is going to be 2 tablespoons of browning sauce. Now we're going to stir this up. Now I'm going to cover this up and stick it in the refrigerator overnight. I got more than I really need. I'm just gonna spread out an even single layer here. It's just a matter of habit, but I always heat my cast iron up before I do anything. Add oil or anything. Heat it up first. The oven's good and hot, smoking, so I'm going to add some olive oil. We'll let this heat for a moment or two. So the oxtail has been marinating for overnight. Now we're just going to lightly brown all the sides. We got about a 15 mile an hour wind, so I'm going to keep it covered up. Got the windshield up, but this wind always seems to add time, but that's okay, because today, once we get this brown, we're going low and slow. Now that the oxtail is browned, I'm going to add some water. I just want to come up about halfway. And as soon as these coals are spent, we're going to go low and slow with top and bottom heat for about 4 hours. Eight coals underneath the oven. Twelve coals on the lid. Well, I'm going to have to do something I haven't done in a long time. The wind is much higher than forecast, and so I'm going to move the cooking setup and use my truck as a wind block. My final coal change, 8 on the bottom. Twelve on the top. The oxtail has been cooking for 4 hours. Let's take a look. Ooh, I am happy. Boy, the gravy has reduced down and thickened up a little bit. Jamaican jerk oxtail. We hope you enjoyed today's webisode of Jamaican jerk oxtail.
How you feeling after eating that delicious dish?
I'm feeling irie.
Great.
I'm Dean the fog crawler. Remember, it's all about eating good in the great outdoors.
I'm Joni. Thanks for watching, and until the next time, happy trails to you.